years and is a combination of traveling exhibits geared at educating young learners, young and old, about the many accomplishments of African Americans through hands-on displays, guest speakers, and special exhibits like this year's offering, As If We Weren't There. Thank you, Christ Church Cathedral, for hosting this year's exhibit and the amazing support that I've received. This year's exhibit began, as many of you know, with a trip to a local antique mall where I stumbled upon a small collection of vintage photographs of African Americans. This was an unusual find. I bought the entire collection, and so began the journey that led to the creation of this exhibit. The photographs immediately spoke to me. I recognized that they were a future project and could be used in connection with the museum. Slowly, the idea began to form. The piercing eyes of many of the people in the photographs seemed to beg for their stories to be told. I am not an historian, but I approached this project as a storyteller who likes to tell the story of history and share it in ways that others might learn and be inspired. I researched Black photographers, vintage African-American photography, W.B. Du Bois's photography exhibit of the American Negro, the work of Deborah Willis, and a variety of well-known Black photographers. The idea began to take shape in the form of a picture collection that would tell the story of African Americans. I worked to create a large picture book of images only that would invite viewers into the intimate lives of African Americans rarely seen. Many people have an historical timeline in their heads with some condensed or omitted events. Go back to your elementary education. The idea was basically there was slavery, Abraham Lincoln freed the slaves, something happened, then Martin Luther King single-handedly changed the laws, and here we are. My challenge with the museum is to tell the story of, and then something happened. In an effort to concentrate on a time period of significant growth and change, I chose the time that marked the end of slavery and the period when Blacks organized to gain their civil rights. This then gave a structure of time for collecting photographs. The dates are the signing of the Emancipation Proclamation in 1863, the beginning of the Civil Rights Movement in 1955. My vision was to create a picture exhibit that would explore how African Americans transitioned from the cruel bondage of slavery to demanding their full rights as citizens. During the period that marked the end of slavery, Blacks were going to school, working, beginning families, owning property, starting businesses, participating in government, inventing and making discoveries, defending our country, and working towards a day when all men and women would be equal. I must make note here that long before the signing of the Emancipation Proclamation, African Americans had begun this journey into selfhood. Through research, one can identify Blacks graduating from universities, working, writing, and making major contributions to our nation's development. Many of us have grown up with the stories of Honest Abe Lincoln, the images of young George Washington, who could not tell a lie when chopping down his father's cherry tree, and white-haired Betsy Ross stitching the American flag. Missing are the stories of Benjamin Banneker, scientist, surveyor, and almanac author. He corresponded with Thomas Jefferson on the topics of slavery and racial equality, and the stories of Alice Dunbar Nelson, writer, poet, journalist, teacher, and activist. She graduated from college in 1892. Dunbar Nelson worked as a field organizer for women's suffrage. She further organized an anti-lynching reform and worked on anti-lynching reforms and served as executive secretary of the American Friends Interracial Peace Committee. When we look towards the history books to tell the story of all of us, there are clear omissions. Documentation by popular culture further supports these historical omissions. For years, the only depictions of African Americans were unflattering caricatures that promoted stereotypes. Blacks too long were portrayed as scenery and not an integral central part of the American narrative, and thus the title of the exhibit, As If We Weren't There. In a small way, I hope that this exhibit fills in some of those gaps. This exhibition is food for thought and an opportunity for conversation. It is important to understand that we all have been deprived because of these omissions. How would the world have been different had we all grown up seeing these images in the world around us? It was important that I did not just download pictures on the internet. I wanted a more intimate feel. I solicited pictures from church family, friends, and neighbors. I shamelessly begged any and everyone for photographs. My diligence paid off. Exceeding my original goal of collecting 100 photographs, I collected more than 300, with some photographs still coming in. Everybody responded with, "I have those pictures somewhere. Let me see if I can dig them out." While some people display these treasures openly in their homes, the guardian of the family pictures often keeps them in time-worn scrapbooks, boxes, on closet shelves, and in dresser drawers. When the pictures emerged, so did a flood of stories and memories which I was privileged to hear. This evening, you have the unique opportunity to ask many of the photograph contributors about the stories behind their pictures. Can I have people that contributed pictures please stand up so you'll know who to grab after I finish talking? These are the people who gave me their treasures, and they can share some of the stories they go along with them. Thank you for contributing. When viewing the pictures, you will notice that they are grouped by similarities. After collecting the majority of pictures, they were sorted into categories that include military photos, romance, family, single portraits, worship, play, and work. These photographs tell the stories of everyday Americans making extraordinary progress. I hope that you'll enjoy this year's offering and come back to visit throughout the month. Hopefully, you'll feel the connections with the people in the photographs as I've developed over these past months preparing for this opening event. After a short video, please feel free to walk around and view the photographs. After the video, we'll unveil the remaining pictures, which is why the black plastic bags are there. There will be light refreshments served. Thank you, church family, for providing the refreshments. There are books to look at, hands-on activities, a timeline, prepared for pivotal points in history. There is a continuous loop of photographs in the display, if you prefer to sit. Please ask any of our contributors to share stories about their photographs. They can be identified by the I Was Framed name tags. Share your own family stories. Please don't forget to sign the guest book and fill out your comment cards. There in the back, the ladies have comment cards if you're handing up because I want to know what you thought about the exhibit. This evening could not have been possible without the photograph contributors, my hardworking family and friends who respond with yes when I need help hanging, creating flyers, posters, brochures, postcards, research, editing, and technical assistance. And thank you for coming and making this evening a success. And now our video.